Hey, what's going on, guys? Cage here again. This time we're doing day 7. Now, I did go on ahead and skip out that part in the beginning where he jumps out of the plane. I just skipped that and we'll get right directly to the day when he starts diving again. But this day is kind of special to me in the sense where I hate it the most. And I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys agree. It's got the worst level design. It's got the worst areas. I mean, the further you go, the worse it gets. It's got a stupid old fart for a boss. But here in the beginning, after you dodge these two rockets and then do this, explode this turret, you can get grabbed here. You can get grabbed here right when you get down. But first thing you want to do is take out these two rockets, two rocket launcher guys. And pretty much, and here, what I'm doing is I'm trying to lure them so I can separate one noob and then use him as a source and chain. But anyway, I mean, first few fights in this day are pretty easy. They're pretty simple. I mean, really nothing hard, and it's actually fun the first few fights. But after that, it just goes from stupid to more annoying. Now, after you kill this, after you finish this whole wave, you're gonna fight three alchemists. But yeah, I really hate this chapter so much. It's again, I mean, it's just filled up with the worst things you can possibly think of. I mean, you just get used to seeing noobs, armored thugs, and berets. That's like, I believe that's like every one of the enemies you fight in this day. I mean, you do, it depends on difficulty actually, sorry. Now the jump right there that I just did there, and the square, that's all buttons not working. But here what I'm trying to do is armor break them so I can use the ultimate technique. Just look how horrible that is. I mean, you missed three times in a row. Now, normally I'd take out my claws, but I'm like, you know what? I know how to deal with him with any weapon, so I was like, why not? Why not try it out the Dragon Star, at least so you guys see just a method, another method. But I mean, that's what the enemy guide is going to be for, but just show a few things here. Again, I'm going to wait for him to get up. Steal on bone. But yeah, I mean, there's just so much about this day that really gets very annoying, and the further you go, the worse it gets. I mean, you go from ship to ship, destroy turrets over and over again, get the stupidest enemies in the game, you're locked up in hallways, and it's just very annoying. I mean, out of all the days, I mean, you've probably already heard me complain about a few of the other days, but this is by far the worst. Now, obviously, this guy being solo, I figured why not steal on bone. Okay, so here, this idiot glitches in the corner. He doesn't want to move. And I tried to do a flank swallow, but it misses. Now I'm going to try to do it again. In a little bit, I'm gonna get hit with a rocket. And see, the camera messed me up there. Again. And don't be surprised if that happens. Now here I'm just trying to weaken him. I should have actually taken out my scythe. Now, if you're wondering what happened there, I was trying to do an on-landing 360, but it didn't work. And that's why he's just stood there. Now, I knew he was gonna block, so if he blocks, you just throw another one and hit, it'll go right through him. Now, here, just shoot this guy the ball. Don't even bother doing this. I mean, I'm just trying to get whatever I could possibly get. Now take this beret out. And once you take this beret out, directly jump to your right and just shoot the bull. Cause there's gonna be a guy out there. But yeah, I mean, you fight the regent again. I mean, he's not hard, but the guy before him, the old fart, I call him an old fart, and pretty much that's what he is, the old guy. He's one of those annoying bosses where you gotta use a projectile to kill him, which is stupid. Now here, I was gonna do a flying swallow, but I didn't want to risk wasting the noob with that. So I'm trying to just be patient a little bit, and trying to get the armored thug with the shield out. No, and also, one thing you're gonna notice is the camera sucks so bad in this level. I mean, just look at this. Like, you can't even keep up to what you're trying to do. No, that's such a waste of a noob. I mean, I was gonna use him for something even better, the chain steel on bone, but didn't happen. Sorry. Now here I do something funny. I actually double steel on bone this guy. And I'm not even 100% sure of how to do this. But here, look. Right after I obliterate him, I slid steel on bone again. And I seen actually a friend of mine. His YouTube channel is Taz, T-A-Z, capital O-N-E, and then the number 1. He's done it in one of his last videos that he made for the game. And look how bad this camera is. I'm trying to turn this so I can do this. Which is pretty interesting. You can actually farm points like that, but it only works, I believe, 2 times. Okay, right here, whatever you do, don't go up and break the machine, because this guy will hit you, and I've had that happen. That's why I'm telling you. And I don't know how it missed there, but yeah. Now here, what I'm gonna try to do is use the rocket launcher guy as a source, but it aims the wrong way and I hit square by accident. Again, no points. It only gives me 500 points. I mean 50 points, just because the obliteration takes 5 hits. But here, I completely forgot there was a guy up there. So don't do that. I mean, that's free damage you wasted for yourself, like I did. But luckily, the next couple of fights, I don't get through them. I get through them without any problems, hopefully. So I mean, just be careful. Try to play it safe. Now this is actually one of the tougher fights, but the toughest fight comes pretty close. I believe it's after the second ship. Now don't obliterate that guy. And I've learned my lesson from that. Don't obliterate him until you kill those 2 guys. Because if you do, right when you finish the animation, they're gonna be running over you with the flame. And it's gonna hit you. Now here, what you want to do is try to gather them up, but use a noob as a source like this. I'm not sure if it's now or maybe it's later. But in the middle of my steel and bone, I'm gonna get grabbed by this idiot. Which is totally unfair. I think it's the coming up one, the next steel and bone. I got lucky there. Now watch, grab. Right when I was about to turn and hit one other person, I get grabbed. I got so pissed off here. But he'll get his revenge. He'll scream like a little girl, like he always does. Now, as far as Nimpo goes, use it when you're low on health. Me here, I personally figured, you know, I can go on a little bit longer before I can use it. I was like, I still have a little bit of health left before I need to use it. Now, normally, my tip would be, if you're going to use Nimpo, use it if you have an ultimate technique. If you have an ultimate technique, don't use your ultimate technique. Use your Nimpo first. And look at him targeting the wrong person again. And I'm trying to target that flamethrower guy, but obviously it's not going to happen. Now here I did something wrong. I honestly should have waited a little bit. Now notice how I dodge into him and then start the stealing ball. This, what that does is it interrupts them and then you can start it. Now this fight actually on Ultimate Ninja is actually one of the hardest fights. It's very hard. And it's not hard because I don't know what to do or anything. It's because you face four helicopters at the end. Two at a time. But yeah, that should do it after the rocket guys. Break these. And then it's going to be two helicopters. There's no checkpoint until you kill them. Until you destroy them. Okay, so use this box right here, these two boxes. Use them as a shield, and don't be too greedy. There's only two of them. Don't be too greedy with your shots. Try to use that as a barrier between you and them, because that will save you. I mean, I usually get hit here. I got lucky, no damage. I mean, this is actually one of those longer days. And it's not fun. That's the funny thing about it. Only thing I like about it is actually the music. Other than that, it's horrible. The level. Design was just so poorly done. I don't understand why they would have done a ship. Now here, notice how it didn't even target the right guy. The rocket launcher was a threat, but it didn't target him. So I manually aimed. All he wants to do is grab. How the hell I got grabbed there, I will never know. This move, learn to use it. It's very good. And I've already told you that a few days ago, but it's such a good move. Now on Master Ninja here, once you finish this right here, the fight that I just did, you're clear to go up to the top. And on the top, there's going to be a lot of bullshit that happens. Yeah, me personally, I tend to switch to Dragon Sword a lot. It's just my comfortable weapon. I really like it a lot. Now, why would he target them when this idiot was coming right towards me? Yeah, so there should be, I think, three of those. And then you got to climb up. And that target up there is the turret, so yeah, don't get confused if you think that's a guy. I pretty much just wait for it to look away and then climb up. Okay, so that concludes the first ship. Now this is the second ship. This is the worst ship in the entire game, an entire level. Well, I'd probably say the entire game. This is probably one of the worst parts in the entire game. But this part's going to be... it's one of the annoying and hardest parts. And it's not hard because of the enemies. It's hard because of how they set it up. Whoever designed it is such an idiot. And you'll soon see. Okay, so once you destroy that, just knock these guys out. Pretty simple. I use the same combo. It works well. I mean, why not use it? So it should be three noobs, one rocket launcher noob, and two armored thugs. That should be the entire spawn. And then you break the machine gun, and then that should do it for the checkpoint. Now here I was trying to use them stealing bone, but I messed it up. I advise if they come after you, take them here. This way the machine gun won't hurt you. Again, remember what I talked about in the intro for day 6 in the snowfield. Snowstorm. It works. I mean, why not use it? Now here I messed up, so I was like, I have to do this. I threw the on landing just for safety. Same thing again. Double shuriken, one after the other. Okay, so that's the easy part on this ship. You can actually even flying swallow that machine gun if you want to. It does the same thing. Now here, before you fight these guys, now normally he'd target the rocket launcher guy, but again, he's being stupid. Now the rocket launcher can shoot me from all the way down there, but I can't shoot him from up here. I was debating here, should I take them out first or should I go there? That wall run, don't even bother. Don't even ask what that was. So here I figure I'll just stand on the ground and shoot him. Now I know, remember what I told you a while ago, if you use a scythe, steel on bone, if there's an armored thug with a shield, it'll work on him. Like, it'll break his shield for the first swing, and the second swing will go through. Okay, so right when you get in here, you're gonna fight, I think it's two berets, so take your sword out. Again, same strategy, nothing hard. Again, me being greedy, you know what I'm gonna do for the second one. Now here, there's one thing I noticed here is when you're in here, when you're in a low area, it tends to miss the flying swallow from their back. Again, no points for that. Now take these two guys out. At least so they won't interfere you when you're out there. Now this is the most bullshit piece of crap in this entire game. Everyone hates this part, and it's not because it's hard, it's because there's freaking two machine guns back there shooting your ass off when you're trying to kill these idiots, and you get interrupted, and you'll see me get interrupted later. Now normally if those machine guns weren't there, I could easily steal on bone this entire thing. It's not hard at all, but because you constantly have to move and block, and the blocking sucks so bad in this game. Again, that same combo. Now there's two spawns of these guys. I don't know how many. Now there, I was trying to get an obliteration, but I couldn't, of course, because this stupid game shooting the machine guns at me. I really wish you could break the machine guns and then do this fight, because it's honestly unfair. I really hate this part so much. And I mean, this is not the worst part for me. The worst part for me is actually fighting the old fart, the old man. And it's not because he's hard, it's because he's annoying, and he's a boss that's just full of crap. It's useless. And here, save your ultimate technique. Don't use it. Save it for the brutes. Now I really didn't want to use an Nimpo here, but I've died like 4 or 5 times. There you go, chipping at my health for no freaking reason. Yet, I mean, again, remember what I said with the shurikens. It helps face you towards the enemy. Shuriken targets an enemy, so, and then hit R1, and that will get you to look at the enemy. Okay, so now I have a Nimpo, and I'm gonna use my ultimate technique to get rid of these guys. Remember, now you have 5 swings, so that's why you can kill more than 3. Normally, you'd be able to only kill 2 of those. Now here, you see what happened. I tried to do a wind run to lead to wind path, but the game didn't respond right. So then I got shot with a machine gun, which stunned me, and that idiot did like a flying kick towards me. And here I'm like, you know what, screw you, I'm just gonna use the ultimate technique. So that ends it right there. I mean, when I used the Nimpo, there was actually a Reaper as well, but I mean, I really didn't want to waste it. Now by now, I mean, this is the last day before day 8, which is the ending. You should have already mastered how to fight the alchemists. I mean, they're so simple. I mean, and you have like a mansion's worth of room here to fight them. So, I mean, you should not have a problem whatsoever. I mean, day two's fight was semi-understandable, but even that was enough room. I think there's five. Now, something you should get in the habit of doing, and it's good. I mean, I don't do too much here, but it's actually better than what I'm doing right here, which is do a wind path and then do this combo, stun them, then do launch them up. And I'm not gonna be repeating the combo because you already know what it is and I've already said it millions of times, but now here, if you're not gonna toy with this guy like I am, but that combo is when they're like that. Now watch out with that grab. He has two variations. He's got that grab and he's got like a self-destructing. Those will kill you. I think those will kill you instantly, no matter how much health you have. So be very careful with that, and not to get grabbed with that. But anyway, when an alchemist is powering up like that, what you want to do is do running triangle, triangle, square, triangle. Make sure the first triangle hits him first, and then follow up with the rest. Now there's actually a guy in the middle that's supposed to grab you, but he's supposed to grab you, but he missed. He failed. But there's, I think, five of these in here. Now, I mean, use the method you're most comfortable with. This is just the way I'm used to fighting them. And once you're done with that, there's three mages. Now these are the mages. Remember what they're as weak as the noobs are. Meaning like you could do square shuriken or even just shuriken, but preferably do square because to weaken them. They're not as weak as them actually. Sorry, but they're close. So you can start that like that. Okay. So these idiots. Honestly, didn't want to deal with them, so I was like, you know what? Look at this glitch right here. It's so funny. So he misses the Zuna drop. He disappears, glitches out of the garage. Be careful though. Like again. If you're trying to steal on bone on these guys, be careful, because if you've seen my day 5 video, you know how much I hate them. Now, I don't know how I wasn't able to obliterate them here, but yeah. Now here I was debating whether should I switch to the dragon sword or not the dragon sword, the scythe or not. But I mean, you gotta love this awesome camera work. I mean, this level's such a piece of shit. It's not fun, it's just garbage and horribly designed. By far the worst level in the game. I mean, we're getting close to the halfway marker here. I mean, it's a long level, but it's probably got one of the most tougher fights in the game. I mean, this level alone. Uh, Oh, did I mention you do kunai climb a lot and a rope crossing? Such fun ideas they made. Okay, so you're wait again for the turret and then go up when it's looking the wrong way. Now this next ship we're going to is actually not a hard ship, it's the last ship that's very annoying. Cause that one's got the boss and more annoyance, but I'll get to that when we get there, so. I mean, how many times in the game have we done this already? It's like, it got old pretty quickly, I mean, come on. You do the same stupid thing, you're right, you same dumb jet comes out of nowhere, it's a huge plane. And it's got this idiot that shoots some machine guns. I mean, it's like, what the hell? We've been through this. I mean, can we see something new? Everything in this game is all repetitive. They copy-paste the same stupid, annoying gay enemies in every freaking level. Oh, it's like, oh, we got a new enemy in this level. It's called a beret. No, we saw him in day one. Anything annoying, I mean, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but the berets, they're so stupid. Like, they will look the wrong way, and they'll do the animation for throwing a shuriken. But instead of throwing it forwards, they throw it backwards while looking back at you, while not looking at you, while their back's facing you. I mean, it's like, really? I'd like to see that actually happen in real life, that you wouldn't be able to do that. Yeah, I mean, you guys already know how much I hate this day. I mean, having to go through Master Ninja again. I mean, Master Ninja alone is really not hard. I mean, the only hard thing here, only thing you really got to deal with, and it's actually hard, and here advises you stick to the right side, because there's a pipe or something that's gonna fall on the left. But yeah, I mean, it's not hard. I mean, the only hard thing, excuse me, only hard thing you're fighting against is lack of response for the controller, which is by far the worst, along with the lag input. Now here, once you cross this amazing rope crossing technique, you're gonna find another helicopter. Now, I don't understand who thought of this to be a genius idea, but also blow the rockets up like I am. But the rocket, when you're gonna fight a helicopter, the way they designed it's so lame and stupid. It's the helicopter already starts raining rockets at you before you even spawn to the area, which is retarded, which makes the damage unavoidable. And then the funny thing is sometimes they juggle the damage. And what I mean by juggle, I hear it evade left. Now, what I mean by juggle damage is like you'll get hit, and then by the time you're getting hit, you're gonna get hit with another rocket. Okay, now this is by far the most stupidest and annoyingest gayest piece of shit out there. And I'm sorry for the language or anything, but I seriously hate this entire area. It's so stupid, along with this entire level. Now you're gonna fight two of these spider tank bosses. They're not hard, but when there's two of them, it's like double the lag, double the rockets, and I'm gonna get hit mainly by the other one. Now here, in this area, make sure your ears are wide open, because you need to be able to hear all the sounds that are going on, especially the rockets. I mean, I've never got hit with a rocket like that. I mean, it's just so lame. Now you notice how I destroyed all four legs. Now I destroy the armors. Now I destroyed the legs. Now I got very lucky there. Once you destroy two legs, it starts to slowly cool down, as in not spam the electric pulse. But it's so stupid. Now here, I got hit in a cutscene. How the hell do you get hit in a cutscene? Oh, two cutscenes, my bad. Two shots. I mean, like, twice there. I mean, it's like cheap shit damage that you shouldn't even be able to get hit. Because they make it so where the camera, you can't use it. Now here, again, when I mentioned day one, if you accidentally trigger the quick time event for a leg and you haven't broken off the armor, just don't touch anything, just to get ready to dodge, and he'll break off of it. Again, I'm gonna do the same thing again. I didn't mean to do that. I just wanted to break off the leg. You see how strong the scythe is? I mean, it's... I remember when I went through Master Ninja the first time, when only the Dragon Sword is available. This was actually pretty tough. But, and I used to usually have... now you know the boss that you actually fight in this, which is the huge mecha that has an old fart in it, and get used to me saying old fart, because I'm pretty going to be repeating it over and over again, which is the old man. Now here again with the cutscene, I mean, it's just so stupid. It's now, if I got hit with a rocket there, it would have been game over. But the game would have thought it was fair. Okay, so that's annoyance phase one. Annoyance phase two is about to start. This guy, oh my god, like, such stupid enemies. Like here, I would say do the 360 triangle, like how I did. Now here I just did the advance move. And the reason I do that, the advance move is, it's very powerful. I mean, why not use it? Now here, sometimes the rockets, depending on how they hit you. Now you see how strong that move is? It's like, but when you're on the ground like this, just do 360 triangle. It's pretty good. It's not as powerful, but it's pretty good. Now here, if you get stuck and you think you're gonna get hit with the flames, you know you can do your on landing, and that protects you. Now see how fast I've destroyed that? I mean, it's... Now this is just the electric pulse time, which is not hard. It just takes patience and dodging, and that's really it. The rockets do minimal damage, so don't worry about it. Now what I should have done in that situation was actually, when I jumped away, I should have just done a flying swallow so I can go further back. Again, I mean... He dies pretty quickly. Now, if you fight this guy in multiplayer on one of the leader missions, oh, he takes his sweet time to die. It's ridiculous. Okay, annoyance phase 2 is up. Now annoyance phase 3, and there's one more after that, so we got 4. Okay, now in Master Ninja, they're a bit lenient. On Ultimate, they're assholes. On Master Ninja, once you destroy this first form, you know you're gonna have the second form where he's... I call it the Hot Wheels form, where he goes around on the wheels on the top that he has up there. If you die on that second form, you won't get a checkpoint on Ultimate. But on Master Ninja, it's luckily you do. Okay, so now here what I do, don't get greedy. Now here you can walk this. If you're at a far distance, it's good to just walk this. If not, you can dodge it. But anyway, what I was saying about the rockets, when he shoots, now here it takes 3 shots to knock him down, but when he shoots the rockets, make sure not shoot too many at the top when he shoots those, because he's going to shoot homing rockets, and then he's going to do 2 iterations, and then he's going to do two super rockets. Now, this is a tactic I developed, and when I did my Ultimate Ninja guide, it doesn't have commentary, but when I did that, I actually just got so frustrated with this guy that I was like, let me try something new. And when he comes dodging at you, charging at you, just do your on landing. It protects you and does massive damage on him. You can shoot your bow in the air once you land, once you get in the air like that. You'd be surprised how fast he died on Ultimate Ninja. Now he's dead. I mean, once he's dead, just stay in the middle. Make sure you stay in the middle. And wait for him to dodge at you, charge at you. And once when it slows down, then you dodge to it. And that's it. But yeah, I mean, those are the two annoying forms. I mean, it's not too bad if you take it slow. Now, this is probably the best part in the game, right here. This kill. This is probably the best kill in the entire game. And honestly, enjoy it. Don't let him talk. Just stab his ass. Once you get to him, just hit triangle or Y. Wish you could just chop his head off too. Stupid fag. Again, I apologize for, say, vulgarity, whatever, but I really hate this day. I really hate everything about it. But yeah, I mean, we're getting pretty close to the end. This is another one of those tough fights. This one and the next room, actually. So, I mean, this level's full of tough fights. Now, one thing I notice here, it gets pretty old. The rocket launcher guys, like, there are times where you freaking shoot them, but no, faggot. There's times where you shoot them and he won't get hit. The only way you know when they actually really died is just pay attention to your pointer meter. See, I know this guy's bloody, so I was like, he's standing by himself, so I might as well use him as a source. And here I think I'm gonna clash in a little bit. I'm gonna clash with the... Oh yeah, the rocket launcher guy. Stupid asshole. I should have been dead when you shot him twice. Didn't. Now, I don't know if you noticed, a beret was actually trying to grab me midway through my steel and bone. Yeah, make sure you take those rocket launcher guys out first. No, actually, I wasn't planning to do that. He stops me again. I mean, it gets old really quickly. It's not even funny. Now you saw that armored thug. All he's trying to do is grab. Now see what happened here. I'm trying to get this idiot, the one I just threw right here. Well, this freak's in my face, so I was like, why not just do a steel and bone? Now here I'm trying to gather them up. But I want to kill this guy first, because he could stand back there and just throw his kunai, which is really stupid. I got really close. I got really lucky there. Now he has to guard. He has to. It's like, can't you just accept death and just move on? No points for that either. Which is so generous of them. So that ends the first form. I mean, okay. I see what I said when he stands back and he spams his kunais. For a kunai, that is very unfair. It takes so much damage. Make sure you take our rocket launcher guys out if there's any. see, that ultimate technique was pretty good. That time. Remember when I did it in day 5 where I screwed up. Again, always take them out first. Man, I'm trying to blur this guy. Another idiot right there. And you see how he was looking forward, but he threw his kunai sideways? That's what I was talking about. No, you're not going anywhere. You're gonna die. Twice. Now here I really wish there was a noob. I really wish there was a noob so I could use as a source. Again, and then there's stuff I've seen people that do that don't get into the habit of doing, but you really need to get into the habit of doing wind path. I mean, it's horribly programmed in this game, but it saves your butt a lot. Because manually aiming a jump like I talked about on day 1 is not easy. Especially if you're trying to like get a beret, you need that homing jump, because there you go. Now you spam the machine gun. And here I was like, screw it. I was trying to go after that. Now here I'm gonna switch to my dragon sword. There's only 3 guys, so get the 2 without the armor, without the shield, and then select the shield. Okay, so that's the first part that's annoying. Now I know this next part's gonna be tough. But then that's why I took out my scythe. And I did die here. So when I start here, I usually go to this left area, because I know there's a beret here. Now I normally never do that. I normally never try actually combo these guys. Which is kind of funny how I even bothered to do that. But just a tip about the berets, if you're actually gonna do combos, they're actually very weak. They're very weak, and so you're trying to do combos. Here, I hate how they did that. In this room, when they do, when you do steel on bone, it takes you into that other realm, and you can't see anything that's going on here. Now you see here, I'm trying to circle them. I'm trying to separate stuff out. Now many players who don't really know how to play the game, they don't use their camera well, and not using your camera is very important. Now you see how I'm trying to space out, because if you're too far of a distance, now here I'm trying to do a wind run, wind path, like that, but it didn't let me. Okay, always finish that guy off. It feels that much better. Now here I'm close to an impo, and this is, I really didn't want to use an impo here either, but sometimes you have to. I didn't kill much. I honestly should use my dragon sword, but whatever. Now this is risky, of course. I really have no health left. I don't know how he blocked. He was facing the... Look at this awesome Nimpo. It didn't even take me in the proper animation. But that guy was facing to the back, so he should have been vulnerable. But no. And I hear there's only a few guys left, so, and I counted, I think it's 5. Or 6, yeah, 6. So I was like... Which made no sense. This Scythe ultimate technique really is not, that makes no sense. Now here I'm obviously the noob being the weakling here. Use him as a source. Don't even ask me how that happened, but I'll take it. Sometimes the game is so unresponsive, and it's so stupid how it works. Okay. Now you notice how I was actually gonna do that launcher. But then because I saw that guy, he was coming towards me, so I was like, no. I need to back off. And this is why I recommend a wind path. Now there, if you're wondering why I got hit, I'm trying to dodge, but it didn't work. But yet again, I mean, I was holding block. I should have blocked it, but the game didn't think so. Now there's three guys here, or one of them, you should be one of them powering up some, yeah, there you go. Now notice how I try to separate them. You need to learn to separate them, and I know people have trouble with them. Also that the alchemy cubes they shoot at you, if you throw shurikens at them, you break them. Now I've actually seen people that, you know, when you stun them with triangle or Y, they slide and they try to launch them. Never do that. When you slide, you risk of hitting them. When you hit them, they stand back up. Now here I could have easily just used an impo, but I was like, eh. Eh, he's nothing hard. And he's one guy anyway, so there's really nothing else to do. There you go, like that. That's what I would recommend you to do. There goes that grab again. Whenever he turns red like that, be careful. Okay, I mean, that's pretty much it. And now all we got's the region, and we fought him 2 times now. I mean, he really shouldn't be anything troublesome. But yeah, I mean, you know what I hate this day. I really hate it. It's pointless. It's got the worst design out of all of them. Sure, it doesn't have many ninjas, which also helps to make a day bad. But, I mean, you've seen the whole walkthrough so far. I mean, it's... This level specifically, it just sucks so much ass. And we've already gone over the how to fight the region. I mean, it's rough. It's the same thing again and again. Just use the claws, make it simple. I mean, you literally can use any other weapon, but the claws make him child's play, so you might as well make him child's play. Now you have so much room here, so much room to fight him here, so it's not like that stupid, that room you were in when you first fought him on day one. Be careful, they grab. It's not like that room, but if you play Ultimate Ninja 2, the trial, fighting two of them along with Alchemist in this room is really not fun. I mean, it's not much room, and for some odd reason it looks like it's bigger compared to the trial, but I don't know, maybe that's just me. You gotta love the camera work here, it's amazing. Now, what I'm doing here is actually risky, and if you're not comfortable doing this, don't do this. After he shoots the fireball, dodge and then do the running triangle combo. Or the YY if you're on Xbox. Me personally, some of the bosses, I like to kill them quickly. This is one of those retards that takes forever to die. Simple basic strategy with the claws, but he just takes forever. And make sure, if you're gonna do it, don't screw up like that. Make sure the first triangle or Y does not hit him, because if it hits him, you're not gonna be able to launch him. Yeah, I mean, he should be dying probably a couple more or so. Yeah, I think one more. I haven't tried it, but I know in the multiplayer you can spam balls and kill him, but there's really no need to spam the ball on him. You can just kill him like this. It's already easy enough. I mean, like, he's already dead. But I mean, yeah, that's really it, day 7. I mean, it's a tough chapter, so if you're struggling, don't feel bad. If you're struggling, don't feel bad. Just take it one step at a time. And I know Izuna drop spamming works, but not all the time. And especially when there's berets, it's not very advisable to do an Izuna drop, period. Unless you take them out. But try to get into the habit of doing Steel on Bone. I mean, I'm not just saying this just for points, but you saw on day 4, that one wave, I killed the entire wave with just one Steel on Bone with the scythe. I mean, just look how productive, I mean, awesome that is. I mean, it's so overpowered, but use it. But yeah, I mean, that's literally it, the day 7. If you found this video helpful, please do all that good stuff. It was like, favorite, subscribe. There's more to come, and we'll see you in day 8, the final day. And you guys take care, and good luck. If you have any questions, let me know. Peace.